Yeah. therefore God also has highly exalted him and given him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of those in heaven and of those on the earth and of those under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. Oh, Jesus, we confess your name. We confess your lordship. We confess your name. We confess the name of Jesus. We confess the name of Jesus. We declare the name of Jesus. We mention the name of Jesus. It only takes the mention of your name. It only takes the mention of that name that is above every other name on the earth or in heaven or under the earth. That name, the name of Jesus. We declare your name. We speak your name. We confess your name. We confess Jesus Christ is Lord. It's to the glory of God the Father that Jesus Christ is Lord. It's to the glory of God the Father that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Jesus.
across cultures, across languages, it's all the same. In every nation on the earth, in every place above the earth, every place under the earth, it's all the same. That name of Jesus. You could say it in any language, you could say it in any dialect. That name of Jesus, that name of Yeshua, that name of Isa,
Yeshua,
that name of Jesus is the name above every name.
Yeshua, Yahweh, 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 Yahweh. You're as close as the mention of your name, Yahweh. I just say your name.
Good Shepherd, our Deliverer, Jehovah Rapha, Jehovah Shalom, every name that you are, Jesus, would you flood the nations with your name? Would you flood the nations with your name? Would you flood homes with your name? Would you flood the governments with your name? You said the government will rest upon your shoulders. Would you flood the nations with your name? Flood regions with your name. Let the earth be filled with your name. Let the skies be filled with your name. Let the seas be filled with your name. Would you flood the earth with your name?
Emmanuel, Emmanuel, Emmanuel.
Every nation, every home.
And a ransom.
Bring a charge against God's elect? It's God who justifies. Who is he who condemns you? It's Christ who died. Furthermore, is also risen. Right now, Jesus is at the right hand of the Father who makes intercession for us. Who shall separate you from the love of Christ? Tribulation, distress, persecution, famine? Paul sums it up. He goes, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. I am persuaded that neither death nor life, angels, principalities, powers, things present nor things to come, height, depth, nor any other created thing shall be able to separate us from the love of God which is in Christ. Just say that right now to him. Just say, God, you are with me.
God, you are with me.
God, you are for me.
God, you are for me.
Heaven's in our corner, friend. The great cloud of witnesses are in your corner, friend. Hebrews 11 goes through the hall of faith and all the fathers and mothers who have trusted God when it didn't seem like anything was going to work. They trusted God, and God brought them through. The writer of Hebrews connects their story to our story. Hebrews 12, he says, since we are surrounded with such a great cloud of witnesses, heaven is cheering you on. Let's lay aside every weight and every sin that easily entangles, and let's run. Oh, when the revelation that he's with you and that he's for you touches you, you get strong, fearless, you get your step back.
Corner, friend. I know you are with me, the God of more than.
rise up.
I know you are with me. This is good news. More than enough. Living inside me. The God more than enough. Living inside me. The God more than enough. Praying, praying, praying for me. He's praying, he's praying, he's praying for me. Oh, I know you are for me. I know you are with me. The God more than enough is living inside me.
I know you are for me.
Yes, you are.
I know you are with me.
The God more than enough is living inside me. Should I go through the valley, you're there. Should I go up the mountain, you're there. The God more than enough is living inside me. Should I go through the valley, you're there. Should I go up the mountain, you're there. The God more.
Of Jesus. I want to come in agreement with the intercession of the Lord. It says if two of you agree on anything, and Jesus lives to make intercession for us, he says, I have prayed for you. Where Satan has asked to sift you. Oh, to the nations right now. Satan has asked to sift you like wheat. But I have prayed for you, says the Lord. I have prayed for you. Oh, Italy, Satan has asked to sift you like wheat. But I have prayed for you, says the Lord. Oh, Dallas, Texas, Satan has asked to sift you like wheat. But I have prayed for you, says the Lord. Oh, nations of the earth, Satan has asked to sift you like wheat. Oh, but nations, I'm praying for you. Oh, you watching behind this screen, Satan has asked to sift you like wheat. But I'm praying for you, says the Lord. I'm praying for you, says the Lord. Jesus, you're praying for us. Craziness happening with the virus, and you've lost your job, and you don't know how you're going to get your paycheck. He's praying for you. He's praying for you. To that mother, that single mother with her kids that no longer can go to school, that's wondering, what am I going to do? How do I keep them entertained? He's praying for you. Oh, he's praying for you. Emmanuel, he's praying for you. Someone online watching who's been plagued with fear. You've just been afraid. And I see the Lord leaning in close to you, and he's whispering, I'm praying for you. I'm praying for you. Oh, he's praying for you.
He's praying for you.
time of intercession. You who are viewing right now, we're praying for you right now. We join his intercession for you. Father, we pray for this city at Dallas-Fort Worth. Oh, Lord Jesus, you have made us partakers of the heavenly calling of intercession. Father, right now I pray for the revelation that you're an ever-present help in time of trouble. You're an ever-present help in time of trouble. Father, I pray for the church of this city. Pray for those that are viewing. God, I pray for the church of this city, for the revelation that you're with us, for the revelation that you're for us. Father, I take authority over every lie of abandonment, rejection, isolation. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray right now that you would break in with life. I pray for the inbreaking of divine resource, the release of finances, supernatural finances in this season. You fed Elijah in the wilderness from birds. You fed the children of Israel from rocks, from heaven and water from rocks. Father, release supernatural provision. Release supernatural peace. Supernatural provision right now. Break the spirit of fear. Release peace in the name of Jesus. Peace in the name of Jesus. He's for you. Church of Dallas, he's for you. You are the God of all comfort. You are the God of all hope and peace. Fire by night and a cloud by day. Can you see him praying for you? So, Father, right now I ask you, release salvation. God, I pray that you would break in with your power in the church of this city. I pray for the church of this nation. Oh, Father, I pray right now that you would visit the church of America. Yeah. Oh, Lord, I pray that you would touch every leader in America with divine wisdom. Oh, Father, I pray right now that you would release gatherings, online gatherings. God, I just pray right now that you would release a move of prayer and worship all over this nation. I just see the revelation of it, that he's praying for us connecting on the earth. Thank you, Lord, for fire by night and cloud by day. Fire over every home. Divine provision released upon every home. Release an awakening. You would release spirit of prayer. We would see you praying for us. Just release your spirit right now all over our nation. God, I pray for the globe. God, I lift up the globe before you. Say the nations are going to drop in the bucket before you. I lift up the globe before you, Father.
Yeah.
Break in with your glory, God. Break in with your power, your provision. You who know 7 billion stories, and you're orchestrating 7 billion stories. Break in with your power right now. Touch the church across the world. Break in with your power all over the earth.
Custom is for you to either pick up the phone and shoot a text message or make a phone call and to call a loved one or a friend, or you shoot that text that says, I'm really going through it right now. Will you pray for me? It's what we like to reach out and say. We like to pick up the phone. Hey, I'm just having a hard day. Will you pray for me? Shoot that text. My finances are really low. Would you pray for me? And you have your SOS group text. You have those ones that you know are your people that you can always text when you're going through it and ask for prayer. And I feel like I hear the Lord saying today, I've got your text message. I'm praying for you. I got your SOS. I'm praying for you. I see your circumstance. I'm praying for you. We're getting heaven's response today. Oh, you who's been asking for help. Heaven's praying for you. Heaven's responding with intercession. Our high priest is responding with intercession. Hebrews 7:25. Therefore, because he continues forever, he has an unchangeable priesthood. Therefore, he, being Jesus, is also able to save to the uttermost. He's able to save to the uttermost those who come to God through him, because he always lives to make intercession for us. He's able to save to the uttermost those who come to God through him, because he always lives. Not a day goes by, not a minute goes by, not a moment goes by that he's not in intercession. He always lives to make intercession for us. So would you release to us, Lord, the revelation of the praying God, who you are, our great high priest, the God who prays, the King who prays, the Lord who prays for his people. You're the praying God, the one who prays for us. You live always to make intercession. You're praying for us. Oh, heaven got your text message. Heaven's got your ask, your cry for help, and is responding. We're praying for you.
My God is mighty to save.
I can save to the uttermost because I live to make intercession for you.
Author of salvation, heroes.
Therefore, he is able to save.
Jesus conquered
to the uttermost.
Yes.
Mighty to save, Savior, He can move.
maybe she called out your name, or whatever it is, this scripture of Hebrews 7:25, therefore he is also able to save to the uttermost, completely, fully, those who come to God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for us. I just want you to put your hands out, or you can put your hands on your heart, and right there, wherever you're at, maybe you're in a public place, or maybe you're at home, or maybe you're in your car, maybe you're watching through your phone, maybe it's a computer, whatever it is, and I just want you right there, you don't have to scream it, you can whisper it, but just to tell the Lord, say, Jesus, I believe in you.
Jesus, I believe in you.
I believe you came and you died for my sins.
I believe you came and you died for my sins.
I believe you rose again on the third day.
I believe you rose again on the third day.
And I believe you're coming back for me.
And I believe you're coming back for me.
And in Jesus' name, Lord, I just declare that anyone who's watching this stream, whose heart's been provoked, Lord, I thank you that you, Jesus, you and you alone are able to save to the uttermost anyone who comes to God through you, Jesus. Through you, Jesus. And so we thank you for authoring salvation. Lord, we thank you for flooding the nations with your name. We thank you for flooding hearts with your name, for flooding minds with your name, Jesus. You're flooding the earth with your name, Lord. And we declare Emmanuel, 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 God with us. In Jesus' name. We love you, Lord. We love you. We love you, Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen, amen, amen. Amen. Hey, if you're watching online, we have another set that's about to take.